An addition of funding of 133.6 billion shillings to purchase vehicles for the incoming members of parliament. This has been unveiled in the new changes of the 2021-2022 budget, which the Ministry of Finance has presented before the Budget Committee of Parliament. The MPs are not happy about the money because it has increased from 200 million per MP as it was implicated earlier. We have the report.
Figures and the trend in the plan, because of the problems we are now going through, cannot be exactly the way things are what are in the plan.
The change which the Minister of Finance has presented to the Budget Committee of Parliament today has seen the 2021-2022 financial budget shoot from 41.259 trillion to 44.778 trillion shillings. The State Minister of Finance, David Bahati, says additional funding is aimed at financing the purchase of COVID-19 vaccines, which have been budgeted at a cost of 480 billion shillings.
The increment of 3 trillion is mainly because of the projects. Because of the projects, externally funded projects, which were not captured in April, and also additional funding for the vaccines and additional funding for the judiciary that we had anticipated to start funding in a phased manner.
Parliament has also been added more 133.6 billion to cater for office space, funding Parliament Institute, and purchase of vehicles for members of Parliament.
Members of Parliament were increased from 459 to now 529. We have also not finished the construction of the new chambers where they are going to sit. And given that, and also the government commitment since the 2006, since the 8th Parliament, of making a contribution towards the purchase of their vehicles. So because of that, we have allocated the financing gap that they had of 100 billion.
However, committee members fumed on realizing that MPs have been budgeted to receive the same amount they received for purchase of cars of 200 million each in 2016, despite the inflation and other market changes. But Bahati told the committee that government will only make a contribution to MPs but not take full charge of financing the cars.
This debate on vehicles has been on for several parliaments, and we agreed as a commission and members of parliament that let government make a contribution toward the purchase. And I think it's a settled matter.
The policy on cars is there. But the policy on cars, which officer drives which car, its capacity and whatever, it's there. But it's being violated. It's being violated, it's being abused heavily. It specifies even the CCs and what of cars which ministers and what should drive.
According to their plan, that the available resource requires that government makes a contribution. We are still discussing that part. Yeah, as far as vehicles are concerned, we are still discussing that area, and we see how we can come into a give and take.
Committee members raised concerns that the 2021-2022 budget is inconsistent to the National Development Plan.
The proud minister is going to go to the country in June and read a budget of 44 trillion, where there will only be 6 trillion for development of Uganda. And members, as members have said, the bulk of our money is going to go to only 2 sectors. You are going to take our money to defense and interest payment.
When we go to the allocations, you have kept some the productive sectors. I wish you'd have done the thing upside down. You should have kept the productive sectors to 100%. Then as per NDP3. Then now, if your pocket is poor, then you'd have now gone to the complementary sectors and given less. Now, when you go to productive sectors, is where you have skinned from 13.3 trillion to 6.5.
While you might see that some sectors are not getting what we had anticipated in NDP, yes, but as the minister said, you cannot talk about production. You cannot compare production with security. they have got to go together. So the most important thing, Madam, Mr. Chairman, is really what is the resource available for this financial year to allocate to different sectors.
The committee also tasked the Minister of Finance to find money to facilitate installation of equipment in Mulago National Referral Hospital. This was after it was brought to the attention of the committee that the newly renovated hospital has no CT scan.
Mulago Hospital
does not have a CT scan.
I later asked the doctor that they said, we have a provision here for space, but we don't have money for a CT scan. Can you imagine a private hospital having a CT scan and Mulago Hospital, National Referral Hospital, does not have a CT scan? You know, you are the Minister of Finance.
Mr. Chairman, let me take it upon myself and my colleagues here. We shall consult the Minister for Health. Really, that hospital ought to have the money, but it ought to have all those facilities.
Mr. Chairman, through you, request or demand that we ring fence a particular figure that will go towards improving those facilities in Mulago Hospital.
In the new budget changes, judiciary has been allocated 152 billion shillings to address case backlog. SAGE allocated more 57.8 billion, UBC 22 billion, and Electoral Commission 60 billion to relocate the headquarters. More 143.4 billion allocated for interest payment. Story by Fred Kajubi for the news in Parliament.